Manila, here we go!
Oh!
Oh, the big kibosh! It's good night, freaking Irene!
What more have they got left in the tank? These two incredible martial artists!
Oh, my.
They're giving it their all! This is one for the ages!
This fight is brought to you by the Venetian Macau. They touch gloves in the center of the cage. Both fighters coming out in the orthodox stance. Adrian Pang with a nice eye guard.
Adrian Pang was so excited for this fight because he knew that Eduard would stand there and trade with him. So he trained specifically for this odd, unique style that Folayang brings to the cage.
As is the case with most Team Lakay fighters, styles his game based on wushu, so fluid kicks and fist attacks, very seamless transition from one to the other.
Looks very stoic, he's just taking the leg kicks, not really even flinching, moving around, waiting to unload that giant right hand of his.
Much of Eduard's work from distance will come from those legs.
Good. He's got to use those kicks. He's got to use those push kicks to keep Pang away from the punching range.
You guys around the world, potentially about a billion of you in 118 countries, can't fail to have enjoyed the entertainment so far tonight. It could get even better. These two are ferocious warriors, and that was a punishing sub kick, wasn't it?
Beautiful cut right into the neck of Pang. Spin to attack with his kick. Pang steps in for a big right hand.
Right hand over the top there from Adrian Pang.
Clip the temple right on the side of the head, and that's such a dangerous fight to, or dangerous spot to catch shots because it sets your equilibrium off.
What's the advantage of those underhooks that Adrian Pang has there, Mitch? What can he achieve with those? Just one of them left in now.
When you have an underhook, you have more control over that person's side, and you can really use it to control your opponent a lot better. But when they have kind of a 50-50 position, it's nullified on both sides.
Well, the guillotine now from Pang.
Nice little roll and headlock.
He's still in there, still in a bit of trouble. If he can wrench that, he needs to lift that body up to get torque on the throat. Trying to just disable him, pulling his legs away.
Sacrifice throw, fall as he went there for a deeper choke. He ends up on bottom now. Let's see what Adrian Pang can do as he tries to work back up to the standing position. Nice roll by Eduard Folayang. Beautiful hip toss.
On their feet and applauding that move from Eduard Folayang. And this from a wushu specialist, Mitch.
Beautiful.
Watch out, back up the head.
There's a true mixed martial artist.
Wrestling, judo, we're seeing a whole new Team Lakay right now. Good control, now he's inside control. Now he's starting to knee the body, soften Adrian up a little bit. Adrian's kind of turn onto his side and start moving away so he can create some space here. But he seems okay, he seems perfectly content to just sit there in the side mount position.
When you think over the years, the Team Lakay fighters have been in with some tremendous BJJ exponents. Jehe Eustaquio in with Adriano Moraes. Kevin Belingon in with Bibiano Fernandez. Team Lakay have picked up a trick or two, and they've needed to adapt.
Yeah, these guys train absolutely all out. They're just such an impressive group of athletes, and I think most of them have a degree in criminology, which means at some point, all these Team Lakay fighters are going to be sort of the police force in Baguio.
That's an end to crime in Baguio.
I think that's a movie that I need to make very soon.
Pang gets tossed onto his back.
Good control shown by Folayang right here.
A glorious crowd here at the Venetian Lakay, loving this entertainment.
You can see Aoki over here in the corner looking very intently at one of his possible future challenges in the cage right now.
Whoever wins this is in a very prominent position to challenge Shinya Aoki for his lightweight belt.
Eduard's come so close so many times to a shot at championship gold. This could be it if he brings his best foot forward tonight.
little bit of distress, but he's on his haunches.
I mean, you gotta have tremendous strength from this position to submit your opponent or to choke out your opponent with no hooks in or no guard from the guard position or even half guard.
Deflecting knee attack to the thigh. Right hand from Eduard as he just pulled out of that move. And Pung looks totally at ease with everything that's just happened. Oh! Spinning back fist that he picked up for you. Followed up by a kick. And at some point, I didn't even hear it. The bell went, but the noise here was so loud that I didn't even hear that bell.
Steve, I am in shock right now. I thought the referee stopped it. Adrian opened his hands like, what was that for? What came first? Was there an inadvertent strike after the bell? Watch this. There's that front side kick. We gotta take a look at the finish there of that round. There's some of the ground and pound from Pang earlier. There's that beautiful hip toss by Folayang earlier in the round. But here it is, there's that spinning back fist. Locks him and then he catches him with a right roundhouse kick. I think that was after the bell.
I don't know where the bell came, before the kick, after the kick, after the punch. I did not hear it. The crowd reacted so loud.
Iron chin of Adrian Pang right there to get dropped with the spinning back fist.
And I've never seen him drop it. He throws that in every fight, but I've never seen him drop anyone with it. Wow, that just caught him absolutely flush, didn't it? Tremendous exhibition of how to deliver that spinning back fist. And that won't be the last one you see in this contest either. His signature move, and it was delivered with perfection.
Beautiful first round shown there. I think this entire crowd is on their feet right now. Very heavy on his feet. He's not really light.
But that's his style, isn't it?
Yeah, he just marches, stomps forward, throws big strikes. Edwards working that inside leg kick now. He's got the right game plan. He's staying away. He's, see how he's staying out of punching range, and he's staying inside his kicking range. So he can still land big kicks, but he's staying around, or staying away from those devastating right hands
and
of Adrian Pang.
Adrian teasing him a bit, just dropped his hands for a second, saying, come on, then come inside. Come and rumble with me. And there he is again, doing exactly the same thing.
He knows he has an iron chin, but after that spinning back fist, again.
This time I think he got his glove up and just parried it. It's like Adrian Pang is a rock.
He's taking that inside leg kick a lot. You know, look at that, he's just beating up that leg. I think that one could have been a little high there.
Oh, right hand, and I thought for a second it had dropped for Lyon. But he just popped back up.
He's got the guard in. He's got to fight those hands. Folayang's got to fight those hands, but he might pop his head out.
I think he might just manage to squeeze it. He's very alert to it. He's got his right hand that's doing all he can to free him of that position.
You never want to just try to pull your head out. He's got to fight the hands. He's got to fight the hands. Get his head down onto the mat.
He's done it. He's done it. And listen to the roar from the crowd here. This is the noisiest crowd I've experienced at a ONE Championship event, and they are absolutely loving this.
Watch out!
Strikes from the bottom position by Pang. Edward Folayang not trying to pass the guard, just comfortable to sit inside Adrian's guard and drop
bombs. Eduard, your fingers, watch out!
Fun 88 fight of the night. Let's reset the whole thing and just hold off for a while.
I think we might be a fun 88 event of the night, because this is one of the most action-packed events we've ever had at ONE Championship. And we've had some killer events. Look at how light Edward still looks. He's got a bounce in his step. There he is again.
Spinning elbow this time. He's gone with fist, foot, and now elbow. And Pang still stands in front of him, asking him to give him some more.
Arnold Schwarzenegger-esque as the Terminator, Adrian Pang, just marches forward.
Pang has his hand in the air, said, come on, then, let's see some more. And you will see some more from Eduard.
You don't want to tempt fate. Some of these kicks are landing with tremendous power from Folayang.
Oh, that was a big, solid, grab right. He's
filled with concrete along with his hands, and he has taken some big shots here from Folayang.
Well, in terms of what the judges may be thinking, with a minute and a half left in the second, perhaps Folayang just managing to catch their eye.
Man, we might need to change landslides. Ever Folayang's nickname from landslide to helicopter, because this guy is about to take off, throwing so many spinning attacks.
I mean, he's doing everything that catches the judge's eye.
It's like the Filipino Bali song, the butterfly, the knife that people spin around.
You have great admiration that Adrian is taking this punishment, but he's got to start dealing out a little bit more. Otherwise, this might just go adrift of him. 50 seconds left in the second.
Good hand fighting, but you can see they're trying to fight for position here. Really intricate battle that's going on inside there. Trying to control the other person's ribs, but on the exit.
Bloodied the nose of Adrian Pung with that.
Spins with the elbow.
And they are landing absolutely flush. And a straight right followed up there. Missed with that left. Pung is taking some tremendous punishment. Tried again, Edward. Missed that time.
Big attack shown by, Folayang's got to be wondering, what do I have to do to put this guy down?
I can't see it happening, to be honest. As you said, there's cement in that body. He just keeps coming forward.
Time!
Wow, this is a tremendous arsenal of attacks coming from Folayang. But just the chin of Adrian Pung is on display here. There he is. Kind of caught. That one didn't land fully flush. Here's the attempted guillotine by Pang as Edward pops his head out. Here's a beautiful, another spinning back fist attempted there. There's another spinning heel kick landed. The wheel kicks keep coming from Folayang, the Bali song of MMA.
Wow. What an offense from Eduard Folayang. I don't think we've seen it quite as potent as this before. And he's facing a man who seems to just be able to take it. It's a relentless barrage to the Filipino. 5 minutes left.
Now he's starting to keep his hands up though, so he's deflecting a lot of these attacks. But he's not really engaging any offense of his own. So right now, Edward is running away from this fight.
But let's just hop back to that guillotine move, where it looked for a moment there as if Edward might be vulnerable. And that surely is what Adrian has to aim for.
All right, fighters,
because
ready?
At distance, ready? He's not achieving what he set out to.
Adrian is still dangerous. He still has that right hand that at any time can come out of nowhere and put his opponent to sleep. So he's still very dangerous right now. So Edward has to keep his wits about him.
Huge right now. Still very much in this. He's still got his wits about him, no question. But my goodness, he was dropped with a heavy bombardment there.
Now he's working from the half guard. Let's see if he can take advantage of this, pass the half guard, get in the mount, and work from a more dominant position. But Adrian's kind of got almost a lockdown position there. He's interlaced the half guard, so he can't really get his foot out anywhere.
Edward's forearm all the while on Adrian's throat or face, keeping that head pinned down. He'll be looking to do it again now that Adrian's just pulled himself up slightly with those abdominal muscles.
And the chin of Adrian Pang is very impressive, but the attacks that, you know, Folayang has landed right now. I mean, he's just developed serious power that he's landing right now. As he, oh, nice sweep and reversal for Pang to end up on top.
Eduard looks at his corner and listens to the instruction.
Adrian's still dangerous. He's so strong and he's so experienced that he can kind of maintain and use this cardio when he needs to.
That
nice
was
elbow
a
right
heavy,
there.
Heavy elbow and forearm. Folayang took big blows there. Can Adrian turn this around? Another elbow grazes the head of the Filipino.
Attempting kind of a can opener there as he was pulling on the head.
This is good work from Adrian. Edward
Adrian's still in this. You know, he's a 15-year veteran, like we said. He's been there, he's seen it all.
Tremendous forearm work.
I think most Australian people would be, it would have been a night a long time ago for a lot of individuals, but Adrian Pang is no ordinary individual.
Oh, another big bruising left elbow.
If he can control this position right here and really sort of dominate from this, from the half guard position and land some significant ground and pound, I mean, the fight's still up in the, I mean, Eduard is really, definitely got a big lead right now, but Adrian's landing some big shots and doing a lot of damage.
Just over halfway through the final round here, 2:20 left. There's that elbow again. The biggest weapon of this third round for Adrian Pang.
There's Folayang's trying to go for a kimura here. He can use this to sweep. It's kind of hard to submit it because he's not really in the right position, yeah, but he could use this to reverse the position. But it also stops him from really hitting him with that left hand.
For it though, isn't he?
Yeah, it's there, you know, he could, you know, but Adrian's so strong. It's gonna be hard to sweep him. His base is so stable.
100 seconds left.
Watch out, the last warning.
He's letting go of it. He's letting go of it.
Goes back to him, Adrian pops out of that.
What it means is he's gonna take more punishment from that Adrian Pang forearm.
Folayang did the right thing. He got the underhook, started to move onto his side, but Adrian, the veteran that he is, stepped over and went back into half guard to keep Folayang in the bottom position. Very intelligent move by Adrian.
Coming up to a minute left of this thrilling fight that has seen this arena erupt at times.
Trying for a butterfly sweep. That's beautiful. A kind of a scissor sweep there. Adrian's just applying pressure with that shoulder now. See how he's pushing his chin to go to the opposite way? That just kind of locks Folayang into that position, kind of lets go of it now. Not really applying that same pressure. You can see the right arm there of Folayang. If he gets it underneath, he's gonna have the underhook.
Now Eduard has the front. Now he slips away.
A little too high up on the head there.
15 seconds.
Folayang's threatening attacks and sweeping. He's trying to advance his position.
Couple of good right hands from the Australian. Is it too little, too late though? Looks as if it will be. What a fight. Ooh. Just looking around behind me, everybody breaking into applause, on their feet. Great appreciation for these two. And of course, the mutual respect that is virtually compulsory in this sport. What a tribute to these two fighters and their camps that they could show such a high level of cardio and offense.
Let's take a look at some of this action. There's that there's that incredible attack. That there, there's that spinning back fist, that drop pang, and then there's the roundhouse at the end of the round.
Just
there.
Impervious to it, didn't he?
There's the spinning attacks that Folayang was throwing all night. There's that big right hand.
That was the punch of the night.
Put him down. Being the veteran that he is, he was able to compose himself, stop the ground and pound attack, stall him enough, and move on.
So come on, who's won it?
I mean, you gotta give the damage and the significant strikes landed by Folayang. At this point, I give the fight to Folayang.
I'm with you. It doesn't matter though. What matters is this.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges, see it for your winner via unanimous decision. Eduard the Landslide Folayang!
Great respect from Adrian Pang. Immediately broke into applause, but yeah, that was the way we saw it at K-side. What a win for Eduard Folayang. And has he now finally put himself in a position to challenge the champion in his next fight?
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.